It's a flat day. It's a flat time. But last night was a peak time during a dreaming period. Had an incredible series of dreams, and so significant that the morning was a great morning. But for some reason right now, feel flat. But the dream had to do with, I was able to catch something in a dream, which was very important. In the dream, it began to get darker, like the sun setting, but it got dark fast. And I found myself, I was supposed to ride a bicycle home, and I was on the bicycle, and it got pitch dark. I said, whoa, how did it get dark so fast? And I said, how can I ride this bicycle? I have no light. And then I started riding it, and the bike had a little generator on it, and it produced a little light. So I was riding the bike, and I said, you know what? That's not enough light. I don't like that. I don't like this. This is not what I want. And then, quite quickly, all of the darkness disappeared, like the sun had risen up and the day broke, but super fast. And in the dream, I said, hey, wait a minute, whoa, wait a minute. How did it get light so fast? Something's not right here. How did it get light so fast? This is, something's, I was dreaming and I caught this during the dreaming. And I said, this isn't right. Something is wrong here. This doesn't add up. This couldn't have been daylight. This couldn't have been a normal, where did this light come from? Or where did the darkness come from? This is not, you know, just normal at all. So to make a long story short, in waking up, I began to think about this and focus in on this. And then suddenly it came to me, you know what? It was like we had light on a dimmer. It's like we have light on a dimmer switch, and we can raise it or lower the light levels. The light is coming from our thought. It's in our mind. Where does the light in dreams come from? It comes from our mind. How can mind make light? How can mind, when we're asleep, see light and then dim it, raise the light or bring it down to darkness or raise it up into full light? How's that possible? And how is it that I was able to catch that and say, wait a minute, how did that just happen? So I realized that the light that we're seeing in dreaming and in this world, actually, is not the real light of God. It is not the true light of God at all. The true light of God cannot be dimmed. We cannot put the light of God on a dimmer switch like that. So what is the light of God is the question. What is the light of God? So a whole chain of considerations happened, and a very fertile period of focusing on this took place. And so we have some characteristics of the light of God, and this just isn't being talked about. I have to tell you that the light, sunlight, is not real light at all. The light in our dreams when we're asleep is not real light at all. We're imagining it. So somehow I've got this understanding of the light of God came to me somehow. And so the light of God, I'll give you some characteristics of it. The light of God is ungenerated. Nothing's generating it. Okay, we're going to focus in on the light of God, that light which can't be, is not dimmable. Okay, up, down, up, down, up, down. It's ungenerated. When we see the light of the sun is generating that light, at least we think it is. It may be our sensory perception, actually, our mind that actually is seeing the light. Interesting question, but the light of God is ungenerated. Nothing is generating it. It's not being generated. There's no source that is generating the light Okay. Like we see the suns, the stars, we see the light bulbs, electricity generating light, fire generating light. We're used to light being generated, right? The light of God is not being generated, it's ungenerated light. It's sourceless. It is sourceless light. There's no source that we can locate. Okay? There's no source that we can locate for this light. We can't point to the sun and say, see, we see the light coming from the sun. See? That's where the light's coming from, or the light bulb here. But with the light of God, you cannot locate a source. You cannot locate a source for the light. It's data free. Data free. There's no data about this light. There's no data you can collect about this light. It's non-collectible. You can't collect this light into anything. You can't collect it. You can't say, okay, I've got some light in with me now, or the light is over here. I've collected this light over here. And data-wise, you can't measure the light. Say, well, there's more of it here, less of it here. This is the quality of this. Not measurable. It's non-technical. It's non-technical. There's no technique to it. There's no way you can study it at all. It's non-stockpilable. You can't stockpile the light of God. You can't say, well, I got a whole bunch of the light of God in this battery here, all right, or in this transformer here, on this power station here, or in this light bulb here, or this headlight. You can't stockpile the light of God. It's non-hoardable. You can't hoard it. You can't hoard it. You can't say, well, I want more of it. I'm going to collect it, gather it, store it, hoard it. You can't. It's equally everywhere. You cannot get a hold of it like that. It's non-dimmable. Okay? You can't put a dimmer switch on the light of God and dim it down or raise it up. You cannot dim it. Non-dimmable. Non-learnable. Not, can you learn the light of God? Is there something to learn? No. There's nothing you can learn about it. Nothing you can learn about it. It is just present everywhere. It just is. There's nothing to learn about it. Non-learnable. Non-teachable. Non-teachable. There's nothing you can teach about it. You can't say, well, okay, now I'm going to teach you the light of God. It's a teachable. No. It just is. It's not something that is teachable. Thought free. Thought free. It's thought free. There are no thoughts controlling it. There are no thoughts modifying it. There are no thoughts generating it. It's completely without any thought at all. Thought free. Ever present. Ever present. It's always present. It's always present. It's the ever present light. This is probably not a word. Uncommoditizable. You can't turn it into a commodity. You cannot take the light and turn it into something else, a commodity, to be sold, to be bartered, to be, invested in. You cannot turn it into a commodity. You can't get a hold of it to make it into a commodity. Unownable. You cannot own it. You cannot own this light, the light of God. You cannot lay claim to it. Nobody can lay claim to it. Never absent. It's the same as ever present, never absent. It's never, ever absent. It's never absent. Never absent. It's everywhere. How can you own it? How can you claim it's yours? Ownership of it. You cannot claim it. Unshining. 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 Shining. The light we're used to is a shining light from the sun, right? You see, it seems to be shining. This light, there's no source. You can't see anything generating it. And it's not shining like a bright shining light or anything. It has no shine to it at all. Completely clear, completely transparent, completely unshining. Non-intense. It is not intense. We view different sources of light like a searchlight, the sun. all different, the reflection from the moon, different intensities of light. This has no intensity to it. You're not aware of any intensity to it. Unfocused, like a flashlight beam. You know, we're used to light, seeing focused light, searchlights, spotlights, flashlights, lights in the ceiling, lights here, the sun. This is diffuse, unfocused light. You can't say where's the source. It's sourceless light. It's sourceless light. No sense of being focused on something. Directionless. Again, we're used to seeing a lot of light having a direction, beams of light, beams of light. When you see the sun going through the early morning shadows, shade through, you see beams of light are going through a cloud. You see these shafts of light. There are no shafts of light. There are no beams of light in the light of God. It's directionless, non-reflected. Everything we're seeing, the light is bouncing off something here, and it's being reflected. By and large, most of the things we're seeing, I don't know about like a fire or a globe of fire, if that's reflected light or that's radiant. I think that's radiant light. But in terms of the things we're seeing, when we shine light on something, the sunlight, the daytime, that's reflected light. So the light of God is non-reflected. It's not being reflected by anything. It's not bouncing off of anything. Non-fadable. It doesn't fade. It doesn't fade away. There's no morning or evening to the light of God. It doesn't fade away. Unfluctuating. There's no fluctuation to the light. No fluctuation and non-pulsating. Non-pulsing. Doesn't pulsate. No pulsation or no reflection. No fluctuation of the light. No pulsation of the light. Okay. It doesn't flicker. There's no flickering. There's no flickering to it. It's unobscured. Completely unobscured. Nothing is obscuring it. Nothing can obscure this light of God. Nothing can obscure this light of God. Nothing can obscure it. Cannot be blocked in any way. Unenlightenable. Unenlightenable. It cannot be enlightened. We cannot bring light to the light of God. We cannot bring any light to the light of God. Non-containable. We can't contain it. We can't put it in a container. We can't put it in a room and contain it. We can't put it in a package. We can't put it in a bottle to contain it. Non-containable. Unpackable. We can't put it in a package. Non-packageable. There's no way we can package this light of God. Fact-free. Free of all facts. The light of God has no facts in it. It's totally fact-free. There's nothing to get. There's no data to collect. No measurements to take. Nothing to learn. Nothing to teach. Fact-free. Unmeasurable. There's nothing to measure. It's everywhere. It's equally everywhere. Nothing to measure. It is unmeasurable, non-explainable. How can we explain it? There's nothing to explain. It's beyond all explanation. It is non-explainable, non-technical. Again, there's no technique to the light whatsoever. No technique. Impossible to derive any technical data or any technique from this light. Impersonal. It's equally everywhere, totally impersonal, equally everywhere, non-special, untransmittable. You can't get this light and transmit it somewhere. Like a flashlight, I'm transmitting this light. It's already everywhere. The light of God is the light of being, is the light of eternal life. It's already everywhere. You cannot transmit it anywhere. It's non-transmissible, all merciful. The light is all merciful, totally merciful, because it is with everyone, everything, everywhere, always non-fading, always with us, never dimmable, never fluctuating, pulsating, never absent. It is all merciful. It is never ending. This light is never ending. It never ends. It is the never ending, all merciful light of God. Ever steady. It's ever steady. It's totally ever steady. Completely steady. Ever steady. No wavering in this light. There is no wavering. There is no changing of this light. There's no fluctuating, no dimming, no alteration, no change. It is the changeless, ever steady light of God. Non-energetic. It is non-energetic. There is no energy. This is not energy-based light. The light we're seeing, we think we're seeing in this world, is basically energy. The light of God is not energy. It is not energy. It is not energy-based. It is non-energetic. You do not see any energetic happenings or activity in this light whatsoever. It's unswitchable. You cannot switch it on and off. You can't switch it. Like a light switch, go to light switch and switch it on, switch it off. You cannot switch this light on or off or in any which way. You can't switch it. It's wire free. You can't wire it to get it to do something. You can't, you know, put electrical wiring or even wireless wiring. You cannot transmit it. You cannot wire it. You can't switch it. You can't do anything to it. You cannot do anything to it. It's waveform free. It doesn't have waveforms. The light we're used to, you were thinking of like energy waveforms. This light of God has no waveforms. It's waveform free light. It is also particle free. There's no particles, no waveform particles. It's neither a waveform nor a particle, nor both, nor neither. Okay? There's no particles involved in this light, no waveforms involved in this light. It is particle free. It is non-transformable. We cannot transform it into something. We can't do anything with it. We cannot transform the light of God in any way. It is unsplittable. We can't split this light of God. We cannot split it. There's nothing that we can split about it. Motionless. There's no motion to it. Absolutely no motion to it whatsoever. Completely free of all motion. It's not going anywhere. It's not doing anything. There's no motion to it. It's non-adjustable. We cannot adjust this light in any way. We cannot adjust it. We can't turn it this way. We can't turn it that way. We can't change it this way or change it that way. There's no adjustments we can make to the light of God whatsoever. None. It is the light of being. It is the light of being. That is what the light of God is, the light of being. It is unbendable. We can't bend this light. We cannot distort it. It is non-distortable. Non-bendable, non-distortable. We can't cause any distortions of this light whatsoever. None. Okay. Unconvertible. What can we convert it into? Can we convert this into energy? Can we convert this into heat? Can we convert this? We can't convert it into anything. It is non-convertible. The light of God, the light of being, is non-convertible. It's unplantable. We can't plant this light somewhere. We can't put it somewhere. We can't put it and plant it, okay? And set it somewhere. We can't set it. We can't plant. Unplantable, uncultivatable. We can't cultivate this light in some way. We cannot in any way plant or cultivate this light, nor can we transform it in any way. It is ungrowable. It's not something we can grow. We cannot grow the light of God. We cannot grow it. It's unharvestable. We can't harvest the light of God. It's not something we can harvest. We can't say, this here is the light of God. I'm going to harvest this and store it for myself. It's unharvestable and it's unstorable. We cannot store the light of God. We cannot store it in any way. We cannot turn it into something that's storable. So there is no cycle of planting, growing, nurturing, harvesting, storing the light of God. You cannot do any of that. You cannot melt it. It is unmeltable, non-flammable. You cannot burn it. You cannot heat it up. You cannot burn it. It is non-reactive. You cannot bring about any reaction to the light of God. You cannot bring about any sort of reaction whatsoever. No reaction. It is non-reactive. It is unpourable. You can't pour it. You can't pour it here. You can't pour it there. You can't get it. It's unflowable. It doesn't flow here. It doesn't flow there like a river or a current. It's unpourable, unflowable, undrillable. You can't drill through the light of God. You can't make a hole through it. You can't drill through it. You can't touch it. It's untouchable. It is untouchable. It is uneatable. You can't eat the light of God. You cannot eat the light of God. You cannot eat it. You cannot eat it. There's nothing there to eat. You can't eat it. Undrinkable. You can't drink it either. You can't drink the light of God. You can't eat it. You can't drink it. You can't touch it. You can't drill it. You can't pour it. You can't melt it. It's non-flowing and non-flowering. It doesn't flower. It's not flowering. The light of God doesn't flower. Okay? It doesn't go through cycles. It doesn't go through flowering. Non-reproducible. You can't reproduce it. You cannot reproduce the light of God. You can't do anything to it. You cannot reproduce it. You cannot make copies of it. You can't copy it. You cannot reproduce it. It is non-touchable. There's no way to touch it. No way to touch it. Untouchable. Completely untouchable. Non-transferable. You can't transfer the light of God over to something. Here, let me transfer it over here. You can't transfer it at all. It is non-graftable. You can't graft it onto something else or graft something onto the light of God. You cannot graft anything at all onto the light of God. Unfathomable. You cannot fathom it. You cannot fathom it. It is totally boundless. It is beyond any sort of fathoming that we can possibly imagine. It is non-manageable. You can't manage it. You cannot manage the light of God. You can't get it to do anything. You can't get it to not do anything. You cannot tell it to do this or that. You can't change it. You cannot manage it in any way, shape, or form. Okay? It is non-catchable. You cannot say, I'm going to catch the light of God. You can't catch it like in a butterfly net. There's no way to catch the light of God. Non-workable. You can't work with it in any way. You can't get the light of God in some workshop or some laboratory. You can't work on it in any way whatsoever. Non-workable. Non-shapeable. You can't shape it. You can't shape it in some form, in some direction. There's no shape that you can give to the light of God. It's non-moldable. Moldable. You can't pour it into some mold. You can't impress it in some way. You cannot mold anything with the light of God. Non-compressible. You can't compress it. You cannot bring any compression to the light of God. It is uncompressible. Okay, uncompressible. So those are some of the characteristics, or we might say lack of characteristics of the light of God. You might say it lacks all characteristics except simply being what it is. Being what it is. And that is the light of being, which is all is the one and only light. And it's the light in which all being is. It is the light in which all being lives. You see, we live in light, the light of God. It is what we live in. It is what we literally live in this light, in the light of God. So you can say it is our life, actually. It's the one light of God without a second. And what we need to do is we need to practice like this, drawing our mind to what the light of God isn't, because actually all the activity that we're engaged with in this world is imaginary mind stuff. We're doing it with our mind, and we think we're working with the light of God. We're not. We're working with an imaginary light. It's not the light of God. It's not the light of being at all. The sunlight is not the light of being. The electrical light, the radiant heat light, the chemical light, the whatever kind of light, it's not the light of God. Therefore, it's not light at all. It's actually not light at all. We call it light. We say it's light. But the light of God is this clear light, is this clear light, is this transparent light. And there's nothing we can, you know, do with it in terms of in the light that we're in this world. We're doing everything with light, aren't we? We're capturing it in plants and then eating those plants. I mean, everything that happens here, we're claiming that all this can be done to light. But the fact is, none of it can be done to light. None of it. None of this can ever take place to the light of God. It cannot be fixated into plants and then, you know, harvested and then stored and then eaten. Whereas the sunlight, we're eating sunlight, energy, actually. We eat energy, we drink energy. And none of this is possible with the light of God. When we see, when the light of God, when we accept it as it is, we realize that it is the life of everyone. That we all are abiding as that light, in that light, as that light, in that light, with no inside or no outside really to it at all. It's the inside free, outside free light of being. So as we play with energy and electricity and all that stuff, this is just a dream that we're having, an idle dream, actually. You cannot store the light of God and then transmit it or modify it or convert it. It's non-convertible. You can't take electricity and then turn it into this, you know, through a light bulb and cause the light to come out. You cannot do that with the light of God. It doesn't have various forms or different, but in this so-called universe, of course, we think we're working with the light of God. We think this is light. It's not. The very fact now that it's dark outside, where's the light? Does the light of God vanish somehow? Is it being blocked by something, obscured by something? Right now, the sun is on the other side of the earth. So the dirt and rock are blocking the light of the sun. So I'm not seeing it right now. How is that possible? Can dirt and rock block the light of God? Or if you're in a dark room and it's light outside, for instance, like the sunlight's outside, and you're, how is it that the wall, with this wood, this fiber, cellulose, some sheetrock, some stucco or whatever, sand, chalk, sand, is blocking light? How is that possible? How is it the light of God blocked by chalk and sand and fiber, plant fiber, paint? Is that possible? All these things are blocking the light of God? Is that possible? Or is it a dream? That we're dreaming that this is possible. And so the wall is there, and we say, well, this wall is blocking light, so I don't see any light. It's dark. just like in a dream. I said, okay, the night is dark, and so everything is dark. And then I said, wait a minute, I don't like this. And then suddenly it lightened up. Because I said, I don't want this. This is not what I really want. And then I suddenly looked around, and everything was completely bathed in beautiful light. It was all totally lit up, everything. I said, well, what happened to the night? What happened to the darkness? So, it's a decision. It's a decision. Now, here's the crux of this video. We have been believing for such an incredible long time that the light of God is on a dimmer switch, and it can be dimmed, that we have the power to dim it or undim it. So we believe it's on a dimmer switch, okay? Now, we can theoretically say this isn't true. Fine. But let's say, okay, that we're going to experience the light of God just right now, directly.